Quick access inventory updated.
Chris, listen to me carefully. I repeat, if you are watching this, you are ordered to immediately follow emergency procedures. I am suspending all orders. I am suspending what remains of the Prometheus Initiative's directives in this location. I'm shutting it all down. Clearly, we have had a major communication failure. The Prometheus Initiative directives were explicit for a reason. If I've told you people once, I've told you 1,000 times, leave these matters to your elders and betters. For my part, I am not angry, just disappointed. I understand we are working on re-establishing live transmission. Your first priority is to upload all the information you have gathered to Orochi Core for review. Leave out no detail, no matter how insignificant it may seem. Failure to follow these instructions will result in immediate termination of your contract. Also, possibly, your lives.
Repair sequence initiated. Repair sequence at 25%. Repair sequence at 50%.
Why is no one answering?
Repair sequence at 75%.
At the Orochi Group, we are all one happy family. Please refrain from doing anything to jeopardize our happiness today. Employees are not allowed to discuss the Prometheus Initiative with anyone inside or outside the Orochi Group. At the Orochi Group, we are all one happy.
Security breach suspected. Initiate emergency procedures.
Why is no one answering? Are any Prometheus Initiative personnel hearing this? Hello? Is this thing on?
Hello again. Right on time. Splendid. Something you should know. The reverberation of recent tremors emanating from Egypt have somehow slipped into our honeyed halls. Now, I realize that a few minor earthquakes might seem a touch insignificant to someone of your esoteric standing, but local geological disturbances affecting the Hollow Earth, well, it is most irregular. Well then, that's enough lollygagging on my part. The black water rises. If one thing's done, another needs doing. Oh, I wish I had a battalion of stout porters to help lift the load. But if wishes were horses, beggars would ride, eh? Right, back to it. We are Fusiliers against Entropy. The train will come. Don't you worry about that. It'll come, eventually.
Come along!
For a moment there, I took you for a fond mirage. Non-homicidal visitors are always welcome.
Thank you.
Quick access inventory updated.
Welcome, welcome. Sorry about the mess. Oh, mind your feet. Pleased to meet you. Pleased to meet you.
Lisa Hui to HQ. Has anyone seen Lisa Hui? Anyone? This is a Orochi call. All sites are requested.
A breakthrough in thought. What we were calling the ages is not, strictly speaking, a measure of time. At least, not in a chronologically stacked order. Time bends. It snaps back like a rubber band to a fixed point. The end of each age was a reset, a do-over. We are on repeat, with variation, as artifacts from the previous age bleed into the next, sending out ripples. Each new age compounds with more artifacts and more affected than the last, skewing the original pattern. There is something that is supposed to happen, but the inevitable is always delayed. How many times has this world reset? How do we reach endgame?
This is an emergency broadcast. The Orochi group has ceased all operations in the region. Any surviving personnel are requested to evacuate the area by any means necessary.
Quick access inventory updated.
My cannibalistic ex-colleagues are a crude experiment. They are an axe when I need a scalpel. It is time to refine my work. It is time to risk myself in the pursuit of knowledge. Tonight, I will take my first microdose of the filth. Doses on such a small scale should allow my body to adjust to the changes without suffering the more severe side effects.
Quick access inventory updated.
Yes, I was 42 minutes into the autopsy of my former lab assistant when he woke up screaming. The filth has remarkable properties.
Quick access inventory updated.
Thus far, my intellect has not suffered under a regimen of the filth. I find I am still able to turn my head fast enough to catch my shadow before it sneaks up on me. I confound it every time. If I were mad, would I be able to do this? I think not. I feel safe in increasing the dosage.
Quick access inventory update.
I have seen the dark universe yawning, where the black planets roll without aim, where they roll in their horror unheeded, without knowledge or luster or name. I have seen things in my sleep. Nothing is as ancient as sleep except for the sleepers. I have seen the spaces beyond. I have seen things I dare not share with Orochi. They who sleep must wake. This is not the first time this has happened. And when everything is gone, it won't be the last. The vermiculated inevitability is horrific and beautiful.
Hello, I am the Doctor. You look surprised to see me. Curious. Do I know you? Have I killed you? Have you killed me? Verdammt! The revivification process plays havoc with my memory. You are here regarding the tremors, yes? Strange phenomenon. The vibrations travel from our three dimensions into the spaces beyond. Perhaps you know things about the tremors that I do not. We play a question game, yes? Very simple. I apply pain, you abate the pain with answers. Shall we begin? Talk, damn you! Tell me what I want to know. Clever! Say something! Anything! What do you know about these tremors and quakes? Very good. I will be less gentle now. Talk, damn you! Will you be more transparent when I unzip your epidermis and deglove your body? Did you feel that? The quakes grow stronger. By my calculations, they originate from somewhere near the Forbidden City. Did you hear that? Yes, yes, you heard it. A voice grinding in the teeth of the angry earth. So puissant. But what is it? I must sequester myself. I need to think. I need to concentrate.
Quick access inventory updated.
The parasitic worm swirls in the eyes of the snail. The snail is compelled to climb higher and higher to expose itself to the hungry sky. Ascension comes with pain. And in the belly of ravenous wings, I feel the swirl of knowledge in my eyes. I am compelled to climb.
Orochi personnel, please report your status immediately.
Local bounty detected. Initiating.
You felt it, haven't you? The anguish of the trembling earth? It disturbs my children and plucks discord in the song of the sentinels. But this does not feel like the maleficence of Agenarten. Speak with my daughter, Mudmoya. She will tell you more.
Sister! Sister! What was that noise?
I don't know, little brother. I don't know. It sounds like thunder and flashes like lightning, but is neither.
Make them stop! I'm scared!
Hush, little brother. Don't be. I'm right here.
Is it over?
For now. But the enemy is digging in the ruins and they are opening the ground with fire and noise. They must be stopped.
You make it sound so easy, big sister. But how can we stop what we don't understand?
We will think of something. Pieces of the city are being taken away from the valley, and the black oil is seeping out of the ground.
I don't like black oil. It gives me nightmares. Maybe it will give the bad people nightmares too.
What if he's right? We should just leave them be, let them destroy themselves.
Just let them go? Have you lost what little sense you had left, sister? Every part of the city they remove, every drop of black oil that seeps out hurts us. Hurts me. I can feel our grip on the Black Pharaoh slipping.
So what's your plan? You always have a plan.
I don't know.
Oh no! It's starting again!
Close your eyes, little brother. Close your eyes and I will sing to you.
Additional assignment received. Initializing.
Thank you.
It hath reached me, O children of the age, that the Maghrabi wizard grew furious with Aladdin. Give me the lamp, he bellowed. But the lamp sat heavy at the bottom of Aladdin's pocket, a pocket teeming with other treasures, and he could not reach it. And so the sorcerer waxed foolish with fury, and he waxed wroth with wrath exceeding. With a gesture, he heaped the earth over the boy by a gramarye. Out of sight and out of light, beneath the earth, amid that ancient hoard, Aladdin cast away all hope for life. The ne'er-do-well, the boy who wanted no other occupation than a scapegrace life, wept. He shed a tear for his mother and all the pain he brought her. He shed a tear for his departed father. And he shed a tear for himself. Aladdin rubbed his hands together for excess of sorrow. He had forgotten he wore the signet ring that the Maghrabi wizard had given him before sending him down into the Thonic halls. This ring shall free thee from all hurt and fear which may threaten thee, the sorcerer had said. And as the boy prayed and chafed his fingers chanced to rub the ring, when, lo and behold, the ring's familiar rose upright before him and cried, I attend. Thy slave is come. Ask whatso thou wantest, for that I am the thrall of him whose hand is the ring, the signet of my lord and master. Aladdin saw, standing before him, a marid, like unto the ifrit of King Solomon's jinns. He trembled at the terrible sight. But the slave of the ring said, I'm sorry, my children, one moment. It's not actually one of the original stories from the Book of 1001 Nights. It was added in by a Frenchman in 1710, I think. But the children enjoy it. And it contains fragments of secrets, like the signet ring bearing the seal of Solomon. A ring captured by a demon, hurled into the sea, swallowed by a fish, caught by a fisherman, and served to the king. A ring that gave the power to enslave jinn, exorcise demons, and speak with animals. But that was one of the many tricks of Wily Solomon. You see, he had not one, but many magical rings. These rings are now scattered and lost and coveted. But I digress. The Atenas camp turned up no information regarding the tremors? The jinn are sensitive to such things. They may know more. Perhaps if you brought an offering to Amir, it would appease him to lend you his knowledge?
Quick access inventory updated. Local bounty detected. Initiating. Access inventory updated.